In this question, we're asked to use the total differential approximation of the function f of x, y equals x squared plus y squared to estimate this particular value, the square root of 2.98 squared plus 4.03 squared. So we can see that what we're really asked to do is to evaluate f of 2.98, comma 4.03. So this is a case where we know the function's value at a nearby point. So note that f of 3, 4 is square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared, so that's exactly 5. We know that value. So what we want to do is we want to use the fact that the two values, 2.98 and 4.03, are pretty close to 3 and 4. We know exactly how far away they are. And so it should be that the function's value at these things is going to be close to 5. And we're going to use this total differential approximation in order to do that. So what is the total differential approximation? Well, in order to motivate this or to remind you what it is, let's have a look at the one-dimensional case. So if f, say y is equal to f of x, is a function of one variable, then we can write that f of x is approximately f of some particular value x0 plus f prime of x0 times x minus x0. So let's have a look at what that means. Okay, that means that we are talking about a function which we're interested in near the point x0. So let's draw the function perhaps something like this. Okay, there's x0. And suppose that we know exactly what the function's value is at x0. And we're interested in what is its value at some nearby point x. So we're interested in what is this value here, and we know this value here. Of course, we also know, and of course, we also know this difference here. So this approximation results from looking at essentially the tangent line. The tangent line to the function at that point there is, at least when x is close to x0, a reasonable approximation to it. And since this here is x minus x0, and since the slope of this equals f prime of x0, the equation of this line is that y equals x0 plus f prime of x0 times x minus x0. And that's really what's happening here. So what we're saying is that instead of getting the value that we're really interested in, we can get at this value right here, which is the value of the approximating line. And then that's going to be an approximation to the value that we're really interested in, especially useful if x and x0 are close to each other. Okay, so that's the one-dimensional case. There's a corresponding two-dimensional case, and let's write that down. Okay, so suppose we have a function of two variables, f of x, y. What's the corresponding two-dimensional total differential approximation? It is that the function's value at some point x, y is pretty close to the function's value at our base point x0, y0, together with some additional linear adjustment terms. One of them is df dx of x0, y0 times x minus x0. That's a partial derivative of f with respect to x at the point x0, y0. And we also want the partial of f with respect to y at that same point x0, y0 times y minus y0. So the picture that you might have is thinking of the xy plane now horizontally. So there's the xy plane, and there's a third axis, say z, and here is a particular point, x0, y0, in the plane. And we have some function which determines a surface that lies above this thing. So this surface is, say, z equals f of xy. For every value x and y, we have the z coordinate. Okay, and we're interested in what happens if we move from x0, y0 to some nearby point, xy. So the idea is that in order to find the function's value at this nearby point, we'll look at the tangent plane to the surface at this particular point. So this is now the tangent plane as opposed to the tangent line, and it has equation. So here's the tangent plane. Well, it's z equals f of x0, y0 plus, well, exactly this thing, df dx at x0, y0, x minus x0 plus df dy of x0, y0 times y minus y0. So it's an equation which is linear in z, x, and y. It depends on the partial derivatives of this function, both in the x direction and in the y direction. That's basically what we're doing when we're writing this down, this total differential, is we are approximating the surface given by this function with a linear approximation, which is this tangent plane. There's the equation for the tangent plane. All right, so let's have a look to see what happens in our situation. So for f of x, y equals square root of x squared plus y squared, and using the point x0, y0 equals the point 3, 4, we find that the partial of f with respect to x, what is that? So the derivative of this thing with respect to x, where we're treating y as a constant. So it's x squared plus y squared to the 1/2. The 1/2 comes down. So then we'll have x squared plus y squared to the minus 1/2. And we have to multiply by the derivative of what's inside, which is 2x. So altogether, we get x over x squared plus y squared to the 1/2. And similarly, df dy, it's exactly the same, will be y over x squared plus y squared to the 1/2. Okay, so now we can write down the total differential approximation. So for x, y close to x0, y0, our point 3, 4, we have that the function's value at x, y is approximately the function's value at x0, y0, which we've said is 5, plus the partial of f with respect to x, this one here, at the point 3, 4. So that will be 3/5 times x minus 3, x0 is 3, plus 4/5, because the partial of f with respect to y is y over x squared plus y squared. So when y is 4, we get 4 over 5 times y minus y0, y minus 4. So this is the linear approximation to the function near the point 3, 4. And it's a good approximation if x and y are close to 3 and 4. So in particular, if we're interested in f of 2.98 and 4.03, then we can say this is approximately 5 plus 3 fifths. Okay, x is 2.98, so if we take 2.98 minus 3, we'll get minus 0.02. That's that difference there between x and 3, plus 4 fifths of y minus 4. Y is 4.03 minus 4 will be 0.03. And so what do we get there all together? We get 5 minus 0.06 over 5 and plus 0.12 over 5. So altogether that will be 5 plus 0.06 over 5. And without a calculator, we could say multiply top and bottom by 2 to give us plus 0.12 over 10, so which is equal to 5.012. So that is the approximate value of this function at 2.98, 4.03. So I've just checked with Wolfram Alpha. So this actually is pretty close to the real answer, which is 5.012115, and then some more digits. So this relatively naive linear approximation works pretty well because the point that we're interested in is pretty close to our point x0, y0.